FBI and ICE agents are scanning thousands of driver's license photos without the public knowing or consenting. That's according to a new report in the Washington Post, which says federal investigators have turned to state DMV records for facial recognition searches. Some agencies actually will be testifying on Wednesday before the House Committee on Homeland Security about the practice. Joining me is former state criminal investigator John Lucich. John, is this common practice and do you think it's ethical?
It is. I mean, when you go to a DMV, you're giving your consent for them to take your photo in return for a driver's license, which is not a right. It's a privilege in this nation. And for decades and decades and decades, you know, I've been a cop since the 1970s, and we always looked at photos of people to identify criminals and get it out to all the patrol cars. It's ever since they placed photos on these driver's licenses, those are tools for law enforcement to have. Could you imagine them saying it's illegal to send a photo out of this homicide, of this guy who killed this young girl? We can't show you what he looks like. You'll have to figure out another way how to do that. That would be ludicrous. I mean, it's the type of crime. Go ahead. I think people are objecting to the type of enforcement. And not the use of these photos itself. They want to enforce some laws and not all laws. But you can't create laws and then tell the people tasked with those laws not to enforce them, right?
Why do you think that there are some police agencies that have said this is an overreach, or some critics that say it's dangerous?
I don't know of any police officer that would say that. It sounds like it's more coming from the mayor and council. You saw what happened up with Antifa up in Washington, where allegedly the mayor told them to stand down, and the police chief is saying that did happen. So my point is, it's more of a political thing than it is law enforcement. I don't know of any police officer. I was a local cop for many years. Then I went to the State Organized Crime Bureau of the New Jersey Attorney General's office. I don't know of any police officer who said, I'm not going to use a photo to try and bring someone to justice, whether it's bank robbery or homicide or kidnapping, whatever it is.
Yeah, I mean, on the other side, if it's solving crimes, who in the world wouldn't be behind that? Even if I haven't done anything wrong, why do I care if you've looked at my photograph, right? I mean, as citizens, do we have any rights to protection when it comes to things like this? I mean, you point out having a driver's license is not a right.
The government has been selling our information to private corporations. Many years ago, during the sentencing of the killer of Polly Kloss, a news agency was able to buy a database of little kids, and they went around saying, hey, look, I could have been Polly Kloss's killer. Got this database now, and I'm coming to your address. I mean, time and time again, the government sells. I was involved in a minor automobile accident, and a woman hit me from behind. All of a sudden, I started getting letters from lawyers who wanted to represent me in some kind of injury claim, which I had no injury claim. But the fact is, within days, they had my data. So if it's available for people to try and sell me something, why? Why in God's earth would it not be available to law enforcement to bring people to justice?
So what do you think that Congress needs to do here?
I think Congress needs to do something with the immigration issue. I think it's long overdue. I think they have to do something that protects this nation and protects the people coming across the border. Because the more people that come across in dangerous situations, oh my God, I mean, it's just horrible situations, but it's not ICE or the Border Patrol that's creating this situation. It is the fact that they know they're gonna come across the border, be released into our country, and who wouldn't want a great life in America? America is the greatest nation in the world, bar none. That's why they're flooding in here. It's always the gate test. Which way are people flowing? And you know what? America has always been a welcoming nation, but we just can't get overrun by people who don't want to obey our laws. So we really need, Congress needs to do something where everybody's happy, and it's more of a place so South Americans and whoever's coming from all over the world can come through the border and come through it legally. I'm sure if they thought they had a chance, they would do it the legal way. And you know what? If you were down there and I was down there, we'd be clawing our way up here because America is the greatest place.
John Lucich, thank you for being with us. We appreciate it.